With just about every accomplishment in lacrosse under his belt, perhaps the only person that didn't know Shawn Williams was a lock for the Whitby Sports Hall of Fame is Shawn Williams.
You know what, it was definitely a huge honor. Surprising, totally grateful and thankful and excited to be part of such an awesome group of athletes and builders, and you know, just the sports in general in this area are incredible over the a long time actually, and to be a part of that it's awesome.
Shawn's youth days were spent in Scarborough, but the connection to the Redmen was a family affair, with Father Greg suiting up for Brooklyn in the mid-1970s, where a lifelong attachment with the team was born.
So I had Brooklyn and Whitby in my veins since I was, you know, a baby. But I have so many memories as a child in Luther Vipon Arena, and you know, hanging out at the Vipon's house with Pete and Debbie's son Kelly, and just lots of fantastic memories, and hanging out in the dressing room with my dad in that dingy basement of Luther Vipon, and climbing those stairs. Lots of great feelings, and I knew I always wanted to be a Brooklyn Redman when I grew up.
The dream of following his dad's footsteps by playing for Brooklyn was realized when his major rights were secured for the summer of 1996. Individual honors would soon follow, winning the first of six scoring titles in 1999. The following year, well, that was a special one for Shawn, the Redmen, and the lacrosse community.
Okay, if I don't ever play another game, I'm good, because this is awesome. But finally, beating Brampton and giving ourselves a chance to go to the Man Cup was just an incredible feeling. You know, it's just the elation you feel, and you're finally getting to do something that you've always dreamed of, and always playing at home on that floor was another special feeling, and it's definitely a special place to play. Again, I think it's the best place to play lacrosse, in my opinion. But yes, we slayed Brampton, and then we played a real star-studded Victoria, and fortunately, you know, we had a bunch of overtime games, but we took him down 4-0. It was just like, we were looking around like, what happened? Like, it was that fast, but incredible feeling, great group of guys.
A trade to Brampton would bring about another Man Cup before Shawn returned home to finish his summer career. And we've barely scratched the surface here. Williams also played an incredible 17 seasons in the National Lacrosse League, split between four franchises, 280 games, over 1,200 points, and a pair of NLL championships. Shawn's career internationally included a pair of silver medals and a gold at the World Championship, as he helped down the favorite Americans on home soil in 2006.
We definitely weren't supposed to be in the mix for that, but you know, the way the field game goes, and it's a technical game, and you know, we had our face-off guy Jeff Snyder, and he was on fire, and that's usually the way that goes. If you win the most draws, you're getting the ball the most, and unfortunately for us, Jeff was on fire for that 2-week tournament, and the rest is history, and we are part of that, a long line of teams that try to slay the international dragon, but we got to do it, just like the 78 team, and now 2014, we did it as well.
51, Tucker Williams.
Now you guys have a connection with some of the coaching staff and players as well. Explain why you chose the numbers you did.
Because it's my dad's number.
The number 51 and the name Williams will forever be associated with lacrosse in the region. The legacy will live forever through Shawn's children and the braver-than-brave movement inspired by 8-year-old Tucker.